This is Jeff Jost, the driver of the United States number one team, currently in eighth place. Jost, a standout wrestler and rugby player. His number two man is Joe Briskey, manages a health club near San Diego. The number three is Tom Barnes, a firefighter from Dover, Delaware, and Hal Hoy is the brakeman, a deputy sheriff in Malone, New York. Earlier, I spoke with Jeff about the sacrifices he's had to make to compete in this sport.
Well, I live about 65 miles from the Barber in Lake Placid, and I have to get up an hour, drive an hour and a half to get to the Barber. And I'm a New York State trooper for a job, and I have to work. So I usually work the afternoon shift. And it's hard. It runs you down a little bit. And I just try and do the best I can. The state police have been very good to me this year and given me quite a bit of time off to go to training in Europe early. I came back, worked a few weeks for the holidays, and then I'm on the same kind of leave again as a New York state law, civil service law, gives us up to 90 days non-chargeable leave time to participate in world and Olympic competition.
One of the last strongholds of true amateurism, Jeff Jost. Quite a story. The team has not had the push times that they have wanted. They do have the sled they purchased for Hans Hildebrand for $10,000.
Jost keeps coming on. 11th place in the first heat, 8th place in the second heat time. He's the 5th best time in the third heat. So he keeps coming on with his sled. He's very unfamiliar. 6:53, their best start of the competition.
Jeff Jost now will try to get comfortable, try to negotiate these curves. He knows he doesn't have a shot for a medal. He's competing for pride.
The bottom part of this course, this sled has been flickering, is the expression. He has been really flying to the bottom. His split time up top has been hurting him a little bit. Let's watch for it out of curve 7. He looks nice and smooth so far.
He looks much more comfortable in the sled, John.
He's nice and smooth. 32-45, 32-85, 40 hundredths near the East German. This is his best trip so far.
He looped a little bit through Omega, but he's flying. He's nearly 70 miles an hour. The best run for Jeff Jost as he flies through the labyrinth.
He's nice and smooth. He's perfect out through here. He's getting familiar with the sled.
What a time for Jeff Jost. The time he needs on the left, his time, 50-64.
Unbelievable.
Puts him in fourth place in this heat.
Unbelievable time for Jost. Every time down this mountain, he gets faster. That's a tremendous time for Jeff Jost.
And he knows it. Look at the teammates. They're tremendously excited.
I tell you, unbelievable. He knows it. I tell you, that is one of the best Olympic efforts by a U.S. bobsledder in decades.
You heard the sacrifices that he's made, the time he spent away from his family, the time he spent trying to compete. And it's all paid off for that guy, Jeff Jost, the United States number one driver. Quite a run. Switzerland's number one driver, Silvio Giovalina, one of the smaller bobsledders, knows what he has to do to get the medal. His teammates behind him will be Hans Stettler, 6'2", 240 pounds. Ord Saltzman, former Swiss national champion decathlon, and Rico Freiermuth's brakeman. Former discus and shot put champion, Giovalina, third place after three heats. He needs a 53.01 to get the bronze medal. He should be able to do that. His big challenge is being able to get a 49.89 to get the silver from the East German Bernhard Lehmann. Now the course record is 49.65, and a 49.89 would be the fastest time of the day.
I tell you, the 49.89 is unrealistic, but 53.01, he's got to watch out, because this is the last man down in the competition. This track is cut up. It's super dangerous.
Now, the key to his getting a silver medal is an outstanding push time, which he has not had in any of the heats thus far.
Outstanding push time means sub-640. He's been getting around 647, 648. Let's see how hungry the Swiss are.
Best time is Ickmanis, 6:30 on the left. His time, 6:50.
I tell you, I've never seen the Swiss start times like this in all the years I've been watching bobsledding. They're usually the best starters on the hill.
It's on the line now. They have to let it fly. He's going after the silver medal. The three men behind him just along for the ride in Body English now.
He's got a treacherous course to ride here. It's all cut up. Got to watch out because Foster's not far behind him. He's trying to beat his countryman now for the bronze. 32.83. About 1,500 ahead of Foster, so it looks like he's going to go for a bronze.
He's got to make up some time down here at the bottom part of the course. Through the labyrinth, he stays very low.
Well, he almost hit trouble there last time. He was good there this time. Looks like a bronze here for Giovalini.
Good line for Silvio Giovalini. The finish line, his time, 50-50. Locks him into third place. Silvio Giovalini of Switzerland, one, wins the bronze.
He knows it. He'll take it. Switzerland will take it. Bronze medal.
Makes his own sleds. Quite a story. Little Silvio Giovalina of Switzerland, number one. Wolfgang Hoppe is the story of East Germany. He's carved his niche among the most talented, best-known bobsledders in the history of the sport. Only three men before him have won two bobsled golds in one Olympic year, but Hoppe distinguished himself even further because at 26, he is the youngest ever to do it. Quite a story, quite a team. So Wolfgang Hoppe takes the gold for East Germany number one. East Germany number two is Bernhard Lehmann, wins the silver, and the bronze goes to Silvio Giobellina of Switzerland number one. The USA finished fifth and 16th. Jeff Jost's fifth place finish is the best since 1956, the four-man bronze in Cortina. So for John Morgan, this is Tim Brandt saying so long from Mount Trebevich.